And welcome back. Conversations about white privilege followed the death of George Floyd. And one professor's tweet comparing a similar situation he was in to Floyd has been getting a lot of attention. And so in tonight's Bridging the Divide, 13 Action News reporter Alicia Patillo now takes a look at why an author says it is important to acknowledge white privilege.
That professor and Floyd were both arrested for allegedly spending a counterfeit $20 bill. He says for George Floyd, a man his age with two kids, it was a death sentence. For the professor, he sometimes tells his story at parties. He ends by saying, that is white privilege. Mark McCoy tells us his arrest happened when he was 18. Having his 12-year-old daughter bring up Floyd's similar arrest drove him to post about his own experience, and it is resonating with tens of thousands of others.
There's a bit of people like seeing in that their own white privilege and never having found a way to kind of express it in the same way that like I'm well aware of it and have been aware of it since it happened, but I haven't had, you know, a place to talk about it, I guess, in this kind of format.
He says one of the things he hopes came across in his tweet was his desire to humanize George Floyd. Both McCoy and Tim Wise, an anti-racism educator and author of a number of books on racism and white privilege, say acknowledging is the first step, but that's not where it stops.
We've got to learn to listen to people of color and black folks in particular and believe them when they talk about their experiences, whether that's with cops or whether that's with employers.
He adds that it's also important to let our families, friends, and colleagues know where we stand in this moment and challenge them on where they stand. He also says we need to recognize that the movement has been going on for a very long time, and we still have a long fight ahead. Alicia Patillo, 13 Action News.
And so you can follow Alicia's Bridging the Divide stories on our website at ktnv.com, including here her latest story about the new murals on the historic West Side and also how they are lifting voices of those fighting injustice.